Well, it's Monday, which means it's time for the weekend box office report brought to you by our friends at AMC Theaters. Continuing its domination at the box office, Deadpool was at number one in its third weekend in a row, bringing in $31.5 million. Taking the number two spot was Gods of Egypt with $14 million. Kung Fu Panda 3 took the number three spot with $9 million. Risen at number four with $7 million. And at number five, Eddie the Eagle, bringing in $6.3 million. The other wide release, 999, couldn't crack the top five, bringing in only $6.1 million. Schnepp, were you surprised by the box office numbers this weekend?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't get out to see any of these films this weekend, but I was bummed to hear about 999 because I'm still looking forward to seeing it. I'm still psyched to see it. But I was hoping that, you know, a lot of other people would dig it as much as I like the trailer. So that's a big shock for me.
Yeah, for me, Eddie the Eagle deserved to do better. It really did. It's a feel-good movie. I don't think people really knew. I don't think it was marketed great. I don't think a lot of people really knew about it. Movie fans did, but a lot of people, like just a casual viewer, did not know about that movie, and they should. I think it's a movie that's going to be caught on cable or whatever it is doing. People are like, that was really a movie. I wish I would have seen that in the theater. Gods of Egypt making $14 million. Shame on anybody who spent. I mean, shame on you guys for going to do that. That's not a movie that should be number seven, more or less number two. But look, who the hell knows how this? It's so crazy. I think I got pretty close in our top five because Kung Fu Panda's sticking in there. There's really nothing for kids to see up until Zootopia comes out this weekend. And then, yeah, 999. I'm curious because of everything going on in the world, if that's just not a movie people were really rushing out to see in the theater right now. It's, you know, Hellcoat's great. I mean, I can't wait to see that movie. I actually missed it. But I just don't know, again, from where we are right now, if that's a movie people are going to go spend money on right now.
Well, I'm not going to say shame on you if you go see Gods of Egypt. If you pay $14, that's not a problem. If you're the studio that paid $140 million to get that movie made, shame on you. Dennis, you see these numbers. What stands out to you?
I was way off on my box office predictions. I had Eddie the Eagle higher up. I agree with Christian. It should have done a lot better. I did a triple feature on Saturday. I did 999, Eddie the Eagle, and Gods of Egypt.
You closed with Gods of Egypt.
It just the timing, that's how it worked out. But Eddie the Eagle was definitely the best out of those three. And I was hoping that it's a feel-good sports movie. I thought more people would go see it. 999, I kind of understand. I saw it. I liked it. I didn't love it like I wanted to. You know, we had John Hillcoat in last week, and I love his movies. Also, I think the marketing for that movie wasn't that great. It didn't really tell you what it showed you the great cast that it had, but it didn't really convey what the movie was actually about. And I think that hurt it a lot.
Yeah, I really like 999 as well. I think you and I are probably the same mind critically for that movie, where it's going to be a great watch on cable, if nothing else. And maybe people saw that and they're like, oh, this is an action movie I can check out once it gets to Netflix. I wish more people had seen 999 because you're right. That cast alone is so good, and watching them work together. But then I was thinking about it this morning when I saw the numbers come in. None of those cast members are going to open a movie huge. Casey Affleck's a phenomenal actor. Woody Harrelson, Kate Winslet's almost unrecognizable, but she is in the movie and she's very good for her scenes. But then you look at like Chiwetel Ejiofor, Norman Reedus, amazing on Walking Dead. Aaron Paul was great on Breaking Bad, but none of them have been proven to open a big movie yet. So maybe that was the problem with 999. It's a gritty action film. So out of all those movies, I didn't see Eddie the Eagle yet. I'm a sucker for sports movies. It's interesting that Eddie the Eagle, and then we also had another inspirational sports movie, Race, open not too long ago, and that also didn't do that well. At least, if nothing else from this weekend, you can take away that Deadpool is still crushing. I'm very happy to see Deadpool doing this well in the theaters. And The Witch, in its second week in release, I think was able to pull in another $5 million, which is a pretty nice hold from its opening weekend. So if for nothing else, witches have a reason to celebrate.
I haven't seen Gods of Egypt yet, and you guys all saw it.
But you love the trailer.
I love the trailer. It reminds me of some weird explosive Harryhausen thing, and everybody's saying that's not it.
No.
Can you, each of you, just tell me in one sentence why you did not like it?
Well, Christian mercifully avoided that one. We drew straws to see who had to see Gods of Egypt and who had to see Eddie the Eagle, and he won. Okay. So I saw Gods of Egypt, and it's like, I didn't hate the story it was trying to tell. I just hated the way it was doing it. You're supposed to buy into the chemistry of the lead characters, and it just does not do that at all. Then when it throws a bunch of crappy CGI at you, Dennis, some of these CGI scenes, you paid $140 million for that? You got ripped off.
Yeah, it was not Dawn of the Planet Apes type of CGI in there. Yeah, I like you. It actually, the base story and kind of like the kind of lore that they're trying to tell is actually pretty interesting if it was executed well. But yeah, it's not only was the chemistry not there, the tone was kind of all over the place. Sometimes at the beginning of the movie, it starts off very serious and then it goes into, it gets really jokey and then you couldn't really tell where it was at. And the whole, like, the where the gods are giant and then the regular people are small, the visual effects for that were pretty bad.
Yeah. And then they're inventing just new powers for the gods to have out of convenience every 10 minutes. Like, oh, don't worry, I know someone that can go to the afterlife and say hi. It's like, what are you talking about?
Perry was talking about Jeffrey Rush on a space boat. In outer space. Like, I want to see that now. I want to see that. So
spinoff.
It's this year's Jupiter Ascending.
All right, space boat two, I'll see that one.
He looked like a grandpa space pirate, but he ended up looking like Weekend at Bernie's in outer space.
That sounds good.
What you want to see.
Hey guys, if you like this clip, click here to watch the entire episode. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel because it'll help you stay up to date with all the stuff we've got going on here at Collider.